Hello? Hello? Is anybody there? Why is it so dark? I don't understand. Hello? Hello? Oh, what's that? Something must be wrong. Where's the lights? Oh, what's this I'm feeling here? Hey, what is this? What's going on? How come I had a scarf over my... Someone must have put this scarf. I shouldn't have put that scarf on myself after I know I have to teach Sunday school. You see, with the scarf, I couldn't even see anything. Not even one thing. See, it's so dark and it was tied over. I wonder who did it. It wasn't my sister. Well, I'm here now. And finally, I have this off me. So... let's teach Sunday school. Let's get it started right here. My name is Sister Charisse, and I'm here with you guys to do Sunday school. We're going to learn about the Word of God. We're going to dive into the Word of God. We're going to search the Word of God. We're going to explore the Word of God. Let's get started. We're going to learn about a man who was also blind, but I wonder how he was blind. Let's get started. So welcome to Future Children's Program, where we dive into the Word of the Lord. Okay, we're going to learn about a man named Saul, who later turned into Paul. I hope you have your Bibles ready. I know I have my Bible ready. I hope you have your books ready, because I know I have my book ready. And I hope you have some things with you. I hope you have your instruments of praise, because I am ready. So class schedule for today is welcome activity, prayer power, and check-in. Recall, I hope you remember what we did last week. Praise and worship song, we're gonna sing This Little Light of Mine, and introduction to lesson, recharge. So we're gonna do some recharge, we're gonna stretch our muscles, we're gonna say some things to clear some things over our life, Bible story time, Bible activity time, and prayer recall and home activities. And sign off. So let's learn about the five finger prayers. This is a prayer that you can do. You don't have to be long to be strong, okay? So I know sometimes you guys are questioning, well, what do I really pray about? Well, if you have this five finger prayer, you can cover everything, all right? So friends and family is the one closer to you, which is your thumbs. The pointing finger is your teaching finger. So it's a point because the teachers usually point. So this is for your teachers, the teachers who teach, and Bishop Thompson who teaches us, and your Sunday school teacher who teaches us, your leaders, which is the tallest finger. So those who lead us, okay? The poor and sick, which is the weakest finger, and you, the little finger, you pray for your needs last, okay? So let's do the prayer. I want you to bow your heads and close your eyes and listen to me as I use the five-finger prayer. You'll see how you can use it yourself when you're at home. So, thumb, closest to you is your family and your friends. Father God, I thank you, Lord, for my family and friends. I thank you, Lord, that you are guiding us and protecting us. Father God, I thank you, Lord, for you are God, and beside you there is no other. Remember, we need to praise the Lord, amen? So we praise him. And Father God, I just thank you, Lord God, for what you are doing in my life. I bless you, Lord, and I thank you, Lord, for covering my family and keeping them in Jesus' name. Pointing finger for the teaching, those who teach. Father God, I thank you, Lord, for my teachers. I thank you, Lord, for Bishop Thompson, Lady Corinthia Thompson. I pray that you'll give them guidance and strength and wisdom in the name of Jesus to steer us in the right direction in the name of Jesus Christ. For my teachers that don't know you, Lord God, I pray that you'll reveal yourself to them in Jesus' name. Amen. Bless my teachers. Let them be prosperous. Let them teach me in the right way in Jesus' name. Amen. Your index finger, which is your tallest. You see the tallest finger right there? You're going to pray for your government. You're going to pray for Prime Minister Trudeau. You're going to pray for Doug Ford. In the name of Jesus and the power of his blood, we put Prime Minister Trudeau and Doug Ford into your hands right now. We pray, Lord Jesus, that they will steer us right, that they will do great things for our country, that we will never lack, Lord God. And I pray for guidance and wisdom for them. And if they don't know you yet, let them know you in Jesus' name. And the ring finger, which is the weakest. So you're going to pray for those who are in trouble and pain. for anybody that's like, you know what, I'm in trouble. You're going to say, like, you know what, I'm going to pray for you. So in the name of Jesus and the power of love, we pray for those who are sick. We pray for those who are affected with COVID-19. We pray for those who are suffering, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, that you will give them love. Give them strength. Give them peace. Dear Father God, in the name of Jesus, and the pinky finger, which is your knees, say, Father God, I pray for myself that I'll get to know you. Father God, I'm not feeling so well. Father God, I'm not doing so well. I pray that you'll uplift me and strengthen me, and I pray that you'll cover me and protect me and allow me, Lord God, to never lack, and that you'll provide for me in Jesus' name. Amen. We thank you. We honor you. We glorify your name, for you are worthy to be praised. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. So this is a prayer that you can use when you are praying. Stick it on your door. Stick it wherever you pray. Let's have prayer power. When you pray, you have power. When you pray, you have power. So drop it in the comments below or put an entry in Seesaw. How are you doing? What are you doing at home with your family? And what are you doing that is new this week? What did you learn that was new this week? And what are you learning in online school? I know you're used to going to school every week and saying, hi, friends, how are you? How are things? And then after, you know, because of whole COVID-19, you got to pray for those who are affected by COVID-19 as well. We are not able to go to school. We're only just you and the teacher, but it's all right. Everything's going to be okay. We are in God, and God will help us, all right? So don't you worry about a thing, but we want to know what you're learning at school and how we can help you, all right? So you can tell us by you doing the following as I fix my tie head here. Drawing, video record, writing, or you can record a message. Say, hey, what's up? How is everybody doing? My name is so-and-so. So let's go into some praise and worship. And we're going to sing This Little Lad of Mine. So I hope you guys have your singing voices. And I hope you know by now that we need to bring some instruments of praise. So let's get it started. It's a lot of mine, let me let it shine. It's a lot of mine, let me let it shine. It's a lot of mine, let me let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. I hope you guys are seeing my screen here. Let me see if you're seeing my screen here. Gonna put it on theater mode so you guys can still see me. Yes, let's sing. This is a light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This is a light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This is a light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Jesus is a light, I'm gonna let it shine. Jesus is a light, I'm gonna let it shine. Jesus is a light, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Stomp your feet. I'm gonna clap my hands and shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. I'm gonna run around and I'm gonna jump the ground and shout. I think I gotta stand for this one. I'm gonna stomp my feet and I'm gonna clap my hands and shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. I'm gonna run around and I'll jump up the ground and shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. I'm gonna stomp my feet and I'm gonna clap my hands and shout, hallelujah, shout, hallelujah. I'm gonna run around and I'm gonna jump off the ground and shout, shout. Jesus is alive, I'm gonna let him shine. Jesus is alive, I'm gonna let him shine. Jesus is alive, I'm gonna let him shine. Let him shine, let him shine, let him shine. Let him shine, let him shine, let him shine. Let him shine, let him shine, let him shine. Okay. Wonderful. So that's the song, and that's going to be in the PowerPoint that I sent to you guys. So feel free to learn more about the song, okay? And to also, as well, sing the song with your families and friends. You know, make a parade, do a video, do something, okay? Okay, let's get started and let's go back to the PowerPoint presentation. Okay, so we are here and we are live. Wonderful. So thank you for praising the Lord with me. And let's get started. What did we do today? Hey, I didn't even have my glasses on. Let me put my glasses on. What did we do last week? Do you guys remember? I'm going to give you visual hints. Do you see at the bottom? I see Jesus, an empty tomb. And I see a cross and an empty tomb. We spoke about Easter Sunday, Good Friday, how Jesus had to die on the cross so that you and I can have a chance of eternal life and make it right with the Lord. And how Jesus rose on the third day, which is Easter Sunday. We call it Resurrection Sunday. Resurrection Sunday, where Jesus rose from the grave. He conquered the grave. He said, nah, man, death don't have nothing on me because I got to save the people. And because of that, we have life and we can say we can go to heaven as long as we walk right with the Lord. So recharge, read your Bible and pray. Read your Bible and pray every day and you'll grow, grow, grow. Say, I will read my Bible and pray every day to connect with Jesus. I will read my Bible and pray every day to connect with Jesus. So what does connect mean? Connect means to join or link together, to join or link together by something or directly or by something coming in between. So I took this from a kid's dictionary. It's a wonderful kid's dictionary. And we want to join together with Jesus, right? So that's what it means. We will connect with Jesus. So we will pray and read the Bible to connect with Jesus. So this is our Bible lesson for today, seeing the light. Obviously, with this red thing that somebody put on me, I couldn't see the light. But we're going to speak about Paul the Apostle and how he was seeing the light. Because before, let's see, was he seeing the light or not? Memory verse for today is Psalms chapter 146, verse 8. The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord lifts up people who are in trouble. The Lord loves those who do right. And the New King James Version says, the Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord raises up those who are bowed down. And the Lord loves the righteous. The righteous is people who do right. So we have two options to do the memory verse activities to help us to remember the memory verse. Option A, you're going to gather some people in your house and you're going to do the memory verse like acting style. So you can get two and three, or you can act by yourself and act the verse together. Or option B, you can have the verse in sections And you can draw the visuals or print out the visuals. All right? So those are two ways you can remember the memory verse. And that is so much fun. So me, I'm going to show you how to act the memory verse. If I go back to the memory verse. Okay? The Bible says, the Lord opens the eyes of the blind. So open the eyes of the blind. The Lord lifts up people who are in trouble. Help, I'm in trouble. I will lift you. And the Lord loves those who do right. Oh, you forgot your wallet. God says, wonderful job. So that is the way how to act. And I'm sure you can do it in many ways. You can post it on Seesaw and act out the scriptures. And this is a way of sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ creatively. So we know option A and option B. Option A is to act with your family and friends or yourself. Or option B is to draw out the scripture. So we're going to view the story. Saul is converted. And the story is taken from Acts chapter 9, verse 1 to 19. But I have a lovely, lovely video for you that you would love to see. And then I encourage you to read with your family, okay? So let us go to the YouTube video. And we're going to see about Paul's ministry.
The miracle of mercy. Paul. This is Saul. Saul was a Pharisee who hated the followers of Jesus so much that he would hunt them down to be brought to trial in Jerusalem. And he would even seek to murder them. Saul was uttering threats with every breath, and he was eager to kill the Lord's followers. So he went to the high priest. He asked him to write a letter to the Jews in Damascus that would allow him to arrest any Christians he found there. He wanted to bring them, both men and women, back to Jerusalem in chains. Now Saul went on his way, and as he came near Damascus, a light from heaven flashed around him, and he heard a voice that said, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? Saul cried out, who are you, Lord? And the voice said, I am Jesus. Rise and go into the city, and you will be told what to do. So Saul got up and he opened his eyes, but he couldn't see anything. So the men who were with Saul led him into the city. After 3 days, a man named Ananias came to Saul. He put his hands on Saul, and immediately Saul could see again. And with that, Saul became a follower of Jesus. He became the very thing he had tried to hunt, and he immediately began telling people that Jesus is the Son of God, and he taught them about the mercy of God that he had received. And all who heard him were amazed. Then went by a new name, Paul, as he began preaching not just to the Jewish people, but to everyone, despite many difficulties like being in prison, shipwreck, and narrowly escaping death multiple times. Paul continued to preach about Jesus. Paul said that he would do everything he could to save people and help them know God. And that's just what he did in order to reach people who would otherwise be unreached. And many came to know Jesus because of what Paul said. Paul taught many in his day through his letters. But even more have come to learn more about Jesus through the letters of Paul that can be read even to this day.
Isn't that wonderful? So, because Saul was changed by God, his name turned to Paul. And that was a wonderful thing indeed of what happened. So, Saul was a mean man. A man who wanted to put everyone who followed Jesus in jail. One day on the way to Damascus to arrest the Christians there, Jesus came to him as a blinding light. Saul fell to the ground and he heard someone speak. He didn't know that it was Jesus. Jesus told Saul that he was persecuting him and to go into the city and wait further instructions. Saul was confused and a bit scared. The light vanished. He stood up and opened his eyes, but he saw nothing. The men who were traveling with him could not explain what happened. So they did as Jesus said. They went to Damascus and waited several days. Do you think someone like Saul can be used like Jesus? And as we saw today, he was. So what does converted mean? Converted means to change from one belief or view or party to another. So imagine Saul didn't like Christians. He's like, I don't like them. I'm going to put them in jail. And then a light shined on him. I just see the sunshine. It's very beautiful out there. And blinded him. You see, but Saul was already blinded. Like I was blinded for some reason. He didn't see what the plan of God on his life. So that God had to blind him some more so that he can see the plan of God for his life. And you see, when you have the power for God, you can do amazing things. And you see, when Saul was changed, he turned to Paul and started telling people about Christians. The man who did not like Christians and got up and started telling the good news to people everywhere. And now he became a child of God. And now he's called Apostle Paul. So let's talk questions. Number one, why was Saul going to Damascus? Just in the video, he wanted to put men and women who are following Jesus in prison. Not a nice man, right? Who did Jesus say that Paul was persecuting? Jesus said that? Paul, you're persecuting me. Me, Jesus. How was Saul persecuting Jesus? Well, how do you guys think? By trying to harm Jesus' disciples and putting Christians into jail. What did Saul ask when the light made him fall down? What did he say? Who are you, Lord? Who are you? So we got to read in the scriptures. The scripture says, who are you, Lord? Let's turn to the scriptures. I hope you guys read the book. You'll read it, okay? Because it's good for you. I only show the video for you because I know you guys like videos. But you have to read the word of God as well. Okay. So let's go to verse 9. Chapter 9, verse 5. Saul said, who are you, Lord? So he said, Lord, who are you? Number 4. How do you think Saul felt when he realized he was hearing Jesus' voice? Do you think he was happy? Do you think he was sad? Do you think he was frightened? Oh, he was frightened. Number 5. What plans did Jesus have for Saul? He wanted Saul to teach his word. Did Ananias believe it when the Lord said that Saul was going to be a changed person? Do you think he believed? Let me read to you Acts chapter 9, verse 10. And there was a follower of Jesus in Damascus named Ananias. The Lord spoke to Ananias in the vision. Ananias answered, here I am, Saul. And the Lord said to him, get up and go to the streets called Straight Street. You will find the house of Judas. Ask for a man named Saul from the city of Tarsus. He is there now praying. Saul has seen a vision. In it, a man named Ananias comes to him and lays his hands on him. And he could see again. But Ananias said, Lord, many people have told me about this and what the man has done. Saul has done terrible things, and what he has done to the people of Jerusalem. Now he has come to Damascus, and he is leading the priests, and the leading priests have given him the power to arrest everyone who worships you. But the Lord said to Ananias, go, for I have chosen Saul for an important work. He must tell about me to non-Jews, to kings, and to people of Israel. So, did Ananias believe at first? No, did not. 7. What happened to Saul after Ananias placed his hands on him? We saw he placed his hands on him. He said, Brother Saul, I am here to heal you under the name of Jesus. And so he placed his hands on him. And what happened? The scale fell off his eyes. And he was able to see again. And he was filled with the Holy Spirit. He was so happy. He's like, I got to tell others about Jesus. 8. What do you think Saul did after he regained his strength? So we're going to read here in verse 20. Soon he began preaching about Jesus in the synagogues and saying, Jesus is the Son of God. Can you imagine? Saul, a person who was persecuting Christians, hurting Christians, and not treating Christians good, people who love God. And now, because he was filled with the Holy Spirit and was touched by God, he's like, I gotta tell people that Jesus is the Son of God. And 9, do you think Saul knew what to say to the people who had been persecuted? So this is an answer for you. Do you think Saul knew what to say to the people who he had been persecuted? I think for me, yes, because he was filled with the Holy Spirit. When you're filled with the Holy Spirit, you will receive power. How do I know that? I'm going to go to Acts chapter 1, verse 8. But the Holy Spirit will come to you. Then you will receive power. You will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and all of Judea, in Samaria, and all the parts of the world. So it tells us in the word that when the Saul received the Holy Spirit and he changed his name to Paul, he knew what he was going to say because he had the Holy Spirit within you. That's what happens when you have the Holy Spirit. You got power. So memory verse again, the Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord lifts up the people who are in trouble. The Lord loves who does right. The Lord opens his eyes to the blind. The Lord raises those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. So let's see here. We have the other activity that we can do, and this is what Sister Charisse is going to do. She is going to write quickly, and I'm going to show you how to split the scriptures in 3 parts. So the Lord gives sight to the blind. You see, the Lord is so powerful. He gives sight to the blind, and I'm going to explain a little bit what that really means. The Lord lifts up people who are in trouble. If you have a paper, you can come and join me. You can come and join me and do this activity as well. You can do this activity at home. You can see who has the best drawing. This is to study the Word of God in a fun and creative way. Who do right? Okay, so I split it in 2 and 3. See here, the Lord gives
sight to the blind. The Lord lifts up people who are in trouble. And the Lord loves those who do right. And I'm even going to put a timer on it. So I got my timer here on my phone. And I'm going to see if I can draw. I'm going to draw in red. I got my markers here. If I can draw for three things in 30 seconds. Do you think I can do it? Let's go.
I think time is going. Oh, time is out. So I drew two, but I didn't draw the three of them. So I just want to draw the last one. Somebody doing right. So this is my drawing. Maybe you gotta give yourself more time. But I'm going to give a hand clap for myself or a pat on the back. I did okay. So let's recharge. Read your Bible and pray every day and you'll grow, grow, grow. I will read my Bible and pray every day to connect to Jesus. So we're joining with Jesus. And this is the memory verse activities that you guys can do at home, okay, with the scripture. And then we have, yeah, Bible activity, the blinding light. So this is a song that we're going to sing together. And this is the verses, the blinding light song. So Saul was blind. He was blinded by God. He was heading down to a path that God didn't want him. So God had to blind him so that he can bring him to himself, so that Saul can go to Jesus, so that Saul can do Jesus's work. Because if Saul wasn't blinded by a light by God, then he wouldn't do well for God. He wouldn't do well for God's kingdom. But even then, before, Saul was blind, because guess what? He was doing things that was not nice. Yes, he could see, but he wasn't doing great things. And remember, God says the Lord loves the righteous, and Saul wasn't doing right things. So God wanted to stop him and say, listen, I have a plan for your life. So I'm going to do something to you that will change your life forever. Okay, so we are going to sing the blinding light. I'm going to sing it for you, and then you guys can feel free to sing it at home, okay? All right. And it goes to the tune, The Itsy Bitsy Spider. Saul was a very bad man on a crucial mission, going to Damascus to persecute Christian, throwing them in jail every single day. Then suddenly saw a light much brighter than the sun. Jesus was the mighty voice asking poor Saul if he knew, treating Christians badly, treating him bad too. Suddenly Saul realized the person he should be, but when he got up from the ground, oh, nothing he can see. But now blind, confused, and helpless, Saul waited three whole days. Finally a man named Ananias came, putting hands on Saul's. On Saul, his blindness was no more, and Saul shared the people that Jesus is Lord. It's a nice song to remind us of Acts chapter 9, verse 1 to 19, and it tells us the whole story of what happened to Saul that turned into Paul. At the end, what did we learn? The final thing. Saul was a good example of how God loves us and is able to show us the way out when we are not living according to his will. Of course, Saul didn't think he needed a way out. He thought that he was going to do the right thing, but was Saul doing the right thing? No, he was doing wrong. So God shows Saul that he needed to repent of his sin so that God can use him. although we have done some pretty bad things, God is waiting for us to come clean and ask for forgiveness. Once we do, we are ready to let him work through us. For Christ also suffered once for sins, the righteous for the unrighteous, to bring you to God. 1 Peter 1, 3, verse 18. It was true for Saul, and it was true, and it is true for you. But remember that when God has something he wants you to do, it might take something big to get you on the right track. Like with Saul, when God caused him to become blind. So let's recall. What did you learn today? What did you do today? And don't forget the memory verse. The Lord opens the eyes of the blind, raises those who are bowed down, and the Lord loves the righteous. And that is Psalms 146, verse 8. And I'll read the new ICB version for you guys to understand. In Psalms chapter 146, verse 8. And I hope you guys know how to go through the Bible. I'm going to do the song for you. The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord lifts up people who are in trouble. The Lord loves those who do right. So study your memory verse, okay? And answer these questions. You can do it through a drawing or a video. What did you learn today? What did you do today? So I will declarations. Let's declare some wonderful things over our life. Repeat after me. I will remember what Jesus has done for me. I will live according to what God wants me to do. I am special because Jesus loves me. I will come clean to God and ask for forgiveness. In Jesus' name, amen. Take home page. So this is the take home page that I'm going to post for you guys. I hope you guys view it and do the activities along with the activities that I will be putting in the PowerPoints, okay? For those who like their Kahoo, you have your tablet or you have your phone. Grab your phone, grab your tablet. I'm going to post in Seesaw a Kahoo for you guys to do to see if you can answer the questions and get the most points. Home Bible activity. So this is a Bible scavenger hunt, and this is amazing. You can look through the scavenger hunt, read what the scripture, and then you can answer what did the boy pick up, and then you have to find it in your house. So I hope you guys do that. And closing prayer. So I got a special book. It's called 180 Prayers to Change the World for Kids. And I'm just going to read one prayer for you guys. Okay, so let's read World Changers. Again, Jesus spoke to them, saying, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk into darkness, but they will have light of life. John 8, verse 12. I have been reading Bible stories all my life. You change Moses and Abraham and David and Rehab and John and Jonah and so many more. Whew. There's quite a list of world changers there. And not all the people were willing at first. I can't blame them for being scaredy cats. I get a little nervous myself. But the cool part is you use every one of these people to change the world. It made a big difference in our lives of others, wherever they want. I want to be like that, Lord. I choose to give up my fears. Oh, Lord, help me. And to look for those who are in need. Give me your ears to hear and your eyes to see. I want to shine brightly, Lord, and not of my own strength.
May I never forget, you are the leader, Jesus, and I am the follower. In Jesus' name, amen. So be the change. So ask a parent to take you to the local soup kitchen to volunteer. You might just make a few friends along the way, or do something that you think that would change the world. Kindness goes a long way. And remember, you have power in the name of Jesus. So that is it, you guys. Thank you so much for joining me. God bless you. And I see you next time. And you're looking for a great treat for next week, okay? Then we're going to learn more about what happened to Paul and the different things that he had to go through. Take care of yourself. And God bless you. Have a wonderful and beautiful and glorious day. All right? And take care. Let me play a song to send you guys off. Just to know that God is a good, good father. Bye-bye. Take care. Looking for your comments. I'm looking for your post on Seesaw. Okay? Bye-bye.
The tender whisper